got punch control set to 50%, so it's pretty high. Thank you. Come here. Oh, shit. He's coming towards me, so I got to freak out. Turn the brake up, so hey, tank. Thank you. Come here, buddy. I got punched set super high because I'm not a big fan of those big old burly backflips or standing backflips. Hey, come here, buddy. Come here, buddy. Nice girl, man. Yeah, it loses a lot of inertia, wheel speed, because, I mean, it's pretty wet right now, and it just flies all over the ramp. So. I like the punch turn down, but the only downside to it is that in-air ground control is horrible. I didn't even click the throttle right there, but let's see if I can give an example. Like if I try to correct in the air and I click the throttle and I'm like at a, let's say like I'm at upside down and I click the throttle in order to get it to continue the flip, it's a little bit of a latency, and so you really have to, like, see, when I tried to correct right there, it was a little, I had to press it quite a bit in advance. Yeah, I got this right now. I mean, I got the temperature cutoff set to, I think, 180 or 190. That's why that guy's cold. I keep my hand on there all day. And that's a 22 tooth, 23 tooth. And, yeah, 22 feet is awesome. And what I've kind of learned, so far is that with this, I was getting pretty hot even with just the 22, but what I found out was I had the punch control set to 0%, so there was no control. And now that I really, really brought that punch control down, this 22 tooth is an absolute beast. I mean, I haven't even full throttled it at all to get up this entire sesh. I mean, not obviously. Oh, jeez. It's coming towards me, so I had to get off the throttle a little bit. But... I've been on it for about 25 minutes now, and she's not even on yet. I need to turn those brakes down. See if we can get at least maybe one full throttle pull in. Oh gosh.